10 years ago, it was quite common for Nvidia to release a full range of GPUs from the same series, ranging from the GT 610 all the way up to the GTX 690. Somewhere in the bottom tier, you could find the 30 series of GPUs. Not really gaming GPUs, but not really only just display adapters. One of these cards certainly was the GT 630, coming in quite a lot of variants, ranging from a GDDR5 version to a DDR3 version, from the Capo architecture to the Fermi architecture. So if you are unlucky and stuck with a GPU like the GTX 630, what are some of the best games you can play on a GPU like this? Well, I can deliver to you some of my favorite masterpieces for low-end GPUs. So without further ado, let's jump straight into the benchmarks. Starting off the benchmarks with CSGO. On 720p with all the settings turned all the way down, we are getting a nice and solid 60fps on average. Not quite playable on a competitive level, but for a casual player, this can be good enough. And of course, you can turn down the resolution even more, getting the 4:3 aspect ratio, on which many players like to play CSGO. Next up is 2016's Inside, an indie title with a very interesting story. This game doesn't really have any settings to choose from, just the resolution. So to get stable FPS, you need to turn down the resolution to 720p. But honestly, considering the game, you can also use higher resolutions. But at 1080p, you will get less than 30fps. In my opinion, that's still playable, considering how slow-paced this game is. I would really recommend this game to anyone who has a weaker GPU, as it runs on pretty much anything from the last 15 years. Next up is a somewhat modern title, and for all those who like strategy games. So at 720p with all the settings turned all the way down, we are getting a nice and stable 30fps on average. This isn't really that bad for a strategy game, and you can enjoy it quite well. But to be honest, the graphics don't really look like a game from 2 years ago. At these settings, the game honestly looks like it's 10 years old or so. But considering that the GPU only cost me $10, and the games run reasonably well, there should really be not anything to complain about. It's really hard to believe that the first installment in the modern-day Tomb Raider series is almost a decade old at this point. So considering its age, it runs quite well on the GT 630. Although, as expected, you need to turn the resolution down as well as the settings. As with many games, if you turn down the settings that much, you can expect not so great graphics. But honestly, the game has a great story, so the graphical quality shouldn't be the most important one. The remastered version of Metro Last Light runs quite well, and even uses the 1080p resolution, which won't really be the case for many games in this video. So even at 1080p, the GPU provides quite nice frame rates, most of the time going beyond 60fps. It's hard to review a budget GPU and not mention esports titles. Especially those that are free to play. So the card handles Valorant pretty well, offering a nice 100fps on average, using the 1080p resolution with all the settings turned all the way down. Once again, considering the price, this is exceptional performance. One of my personal favorites in the series, Assassin's Creed Rogue, runs very well on the GT 630, even using the 1080p resolution, but of course, most of the settings are turned all the way down. Regardless of that, the game looks decent. This shows you that most of the titles released before Assassin's Creed Rogue can run pretty well on this GPU. Next up is a completely different genre of games, namely Outlast 2, which runs on a wide variety of cards considering that it supports DirectX 10.1. So on a GT 630 you can expect to run it on 720p with all of the settings turned all the way down on the DirectX 11 mode, getting in return a 30 to 40fps experience. Considering the nature of the game, this is perfectly playable for me. No budget GPU benchmark can be complete without the famous masterpiece called GTA 5, which on the GT 630 runs reasonably well, using the 720p resolution, getting 40fps on average. As we are used to it by now, the game doesn't look that good, but once again to mention, the price of the GPU is only around $10, so there isn't that much to complain about. The game runs, and that's all that counts. One of my all-time favorite games must be Wolfenstein The New Order, as it offers a massive single-player campaign of 16 hours. Compared to GTA 5's main story, which lasts 23 hours, this is obviously quite impressive for a first-person shooter game. And not to mention the great optimization of the game, running on quite a variety of GPUs, with no exception to the GT 630. As expected, you need to heavily reduce the settings. But even with quite reduced settings, the game looks quite good, offering FPS into the 40s. So, not really the 60fps that most people would like in a first-person shooter game. But honestly, considering the hardware it's running on, this is very good performance. So if you haven't played this game, give it a try, it's really worth it. A few honorable mentions from the games that must run on this GPU from my experience are Titanfall 2, Far Cry 3 and Dark Souls 2, for example. But there are many more games from the last decade that can run on a GPU like this. I have just listed out the games I would play on a GPU like this. I just hope I helped you a little bit in choosing a game for you. As for the GT 630, well, it's quite terrible for modern day standards. But for someone like a casual gamer and with a good price of $10, this GPU can give you a lot of fun. But keep in mind that in order to run the games like I did, you need a proper quad-core CPU, preferably from the 2nd or 3rd gen i5 series, and at least 8GB of RAM. So this concludes today's GPU review. I hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully, you tune in for the next one as well.